We turned it on for the earlier class, so it'd be warm for you guys, but I'd rather not have the sound going.
Sound, got it. Thought you were calling the one in the corner.
Yeah, no, I appreciate that. But then I heard it, I was like, oh no, I think I, everything's backwards. Count five. Every inhalation. We'll exhale for count five. What we're interested in is the ease of breath.
Just trying to shut it off because I just know it's gonna ring. You know, I have that feeling.
We're interested in the ease of the breath, not can you do it. So there's a softness, a gentleness, an ease to the breath. Five count inhalation, five count exhalation. The second exhalation will be a six count. Third exhalation will be a seven count. The fourth exhalation will be an eight count. On up to 10. Every inhalation is five. Every part of every breath cycle is ease. We'll start with an inhale through the nose. third, seven count. And you're still in your head.
You spend more time counting than meditating.
Comments, feedback?
I think that breathing practices are some of the best parts of our meditation class. If not the very best. But I don't want to say that. I don't want to even judge. You know, it's like it's just so good.
It's hard to say what the best part is. We don't care, it's the worst part. The best part. You'll be watching, taking it, and it's like, what?
Yeah. Do you mean to say that?
Yeah, right. Okay, so how was our week of practice?
State in specific actions. So right now I'm doing renovation in my house, which means I feel homeless for a month. And so part of my way to not feel homeless for a month is that at the end of every workday, I have specific things that I go through to kind of reestablish my space.
Yeah.
And so that was part of it. So last night I had a fun 4-hour calligraphy meditation painting.
Calligraphy meditation. Is that what you? Right.
Yeah.
Very nice.
When that calligraphy was done by Jean Jean. Did that circle at the bottom. It was so, you're squatting really low. I'm like a 70-year-old guy. Really low. And he was this close. And his whole body was doing a circle. Like if a circle took 30 seconds, you know. And it just has this real kung fu, like real single-mindedness, right? And wholeheartedness and attentiveness and presence. And it's doing that. Oh, he's squatting really low. And he's, you're entranced for a lot of reasons, but partly just sort of the pace and the quality is just doing this circle. And then when he got to the end, he just was like a model rocket, just pow, just like all of the energy of the circle was just released, and he just hopped up, and it was as if you saw somebody get enlightened, like he was just like, you know, and he was just. You know, he wasn't doing a show, and he wasn't like, now I'm done, I'm happy to be done. It was like actually the result of the circle. It just reached like a crescendo, you know, or something. And everybody watching is just kind of, as he does it, you're more, and then, you know, and he just hopped up, and he's just, his feet left the ground, and everything was alive, and he's like, ah! Like, you know, like crazed, you know. And I was like, that's the one, Sean, thank you. pretty cool moment. says farm.
That's a pretty big pen then. It's going to be this wide, right?
Brush even.
Brush.
Okay. Three left. How was your week of practice?
I practiced some. And that was a really challenging week. And really noticing how much spring fever is a factor. There's so many people were saying, you know, they said, I just felt this way or that. And people were expressing a lot of sort of consternation and things like spring fever, which I hadn't really heard that much of before, but I guess every year about this time, just before Easter, there is this tension in the air between people. I think it's just a desire for sun now, just the renewal. Anyway, I experienced it at Staples and the auto dealership, and I was like pretty bipolar-ish. But you know, I need to like label myself in that way. But I found that my reactions were extreme. And but also, I have also had a very good week on the other hand. You know, interesting reading Krishnamurti, practicing a little bit more, feeling really good, getting a little sun like today or last Friday.
So how's your practice?
Good, I think good. I feel really very centered. I feel able to breathe. Less thinking about what is and sort of some experiencing of it in and out as usual.
Yeah. And how about you? You were traveling, right?
I was traveling. I saw a lot of training, and
that's no challenge.
And also, a lot of people all excited and running a lot. And then there was this awesome party.
No, don't read it, no. You were here early, you could have turned it off.
I thought it was my 7:10 reminder, but it wasn't. I need one of those, I think.
No, don't get into your phone. Yeah. Tell me about your practice.
So, I still haven't really practiced yet outside of class. So there's not much to report, I guess, on that.
Did you take any notes, read any notes, write any thoughts, do any reading, think about practice?
No.
Those were all options.
Right. Yeah. I'm going to put some structures in place, set myself a little alarm like that.
Yeah.
There's a reminder. This app that
just
kind of gives you morning ritual.
Yeah,
and I think I can either put a spot in there or.
One thing I like to recommend sometimes I put Steve's video lessons on, just put it next to my bed and turn it on so I can listen to it while I'm falling asleep sometimes.
Yeah, that's probably a lot of
time. Or when you wake up in the middle of the night and you just, and it's some, you know.
Wake up in the middle of the night.
And it's a great way to relax your mind or change your state of mind so that you can maybe just take that 1 minute just to breathe and be there, you know.
Just to breathe, yeah.
But hearing your voice and hearing the sound of sometimes the stream or the birds or the wind or, you know, I don't necessarily like it. I do like it. But at least I'm having a conflict. I don't know.
I listen to Steve, he puts me to sleep.
And I'm like,
it's a way to get in, you know, where I think, oh, I'll listen to this for an hour, maybe not, but I am going to fall asleep.
You can subscribe to the daily YouTube ones, you know, and then they might, I don't know how it works as an end user, but it may send a reminder there's a new one on the playlist.
Yeah,
I get.
I'm not sure how that works.
I get
But that may be longer than you have time for, you know, so if you set your own thing, you could do 2 minutes every day or whatever. That,
what's the YouTube channel?
Send you a link or somebody will in the class.
Cool.
It's just a playlist that I do for the other ones. And I don't have a long form one, so you know, if you want to add something in the background, it's nature-y, yeah, you could try that. When you were getting here.
I know. I know. You know, actually, I was going to say that it was a lot of breathing, just breathing. Reminders and techniques, and just to bring me back to a calm state. But all of a sudden, when you said you knew, I did take some time and sit and do some meditation over the weekend.
Mm-hmm.
I had forgotten, but I did.
How did it feel before you did it?
Oh,
like knowing knowing you were about to.
Well, I did it because I was feeling extremely overwhelmed by nothing,
mm-hmm.
except everything going on in my head, but like nothing that had any substance, I guess I
mm-hmm.
should say.
Mm-hmm.
And so I said, "This is ridiculous," and I, or something like that.
Yeah.
And you know, I reprimanded myself somehow, and then I decided that I was going to go upstairs and sit down and just give myself some time, because it's okay to do that.
So once you determined you were going to do that,
mm-hmm.
how did it feel?
Better.
Yeah, before you even meditated. Once you determined, I'm about to go meditate, give myself this permission.
Yeah.
And then soon after, you confront the challenge of, now I have to do it.
Oh, but I... Yeah, that's like another task, but it's not, it doesn't have the same weight as
mm-hmm.
the other. I wanted to do it.
Mm-hmm.
So it was, it all was positive.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Nice. You had to feel positive, I guess, as opposed
yeah.
to that looming, like overwhelming.
Yeah,
yeah, it didn't, wasn't it? It helped me to gain some better perspective of my day.
Good.
Yeah. It just sometimes it takes.
So how hard was that for everybody?
To share.
To touch
well,
about
well, you know, it's not. I didn't even know I had to practice until it got to me.
You should have 10 minutes.
Yeah. It was like pulling teeth for all of us, wasn't it? Or for you to bucket last
time. I was giggling because so my Sunday morning class, we have 2 pieces of homework, one is to reflect on the previous class and to share, you know, thoughts and, you know, things of God and how we apply the lessons, and the other is to keep a meditation journal.
Uh-huh.
Or a log more than a journal. Though there's an opportunity to
right.
talk about it. I was like, because they're just, you know, most of these people, meditation isn't a thing, it's really in their life. And so, they're just like, you know, just sit and, you know, be still and quiet and don't do anything for 5 minutes. Like, just be there, just as a start. Like, 5 minutes each day,
yeah.
and then write down that you did it, and that's your homework.
And then they remember, or they
well,
look it up.
Yeah.
Well, and then in each class, they're... The teacher is talking about a specific mindfulness practice, and like every week people are adding something to do for meditation.
Yeah.
So, but the start of it is just like, just sit still, don't do anything else, just be there
mm-hmm.
for 5 minutes
yeah.
each day. And then right now.
Yeah. And I mean, that's how you have to start. And you have to be consistent. But
well, and 5 minutes is such a small thing, right?
Right.
No matter how busy you are, like 5 minutes.
Exactly.
Those are 5 minutes.
Yeah. Yeah. And then I think it takes 25 take, like, to, because your brain waves will eventually change, but I think it has to be 45 minutes.
Has to.
Oh, come on, I didn't say the other word.
Yeah. have to is Roger your way around, should it? So, yeah, it can't take that much time, but it can be instantaneous and it can be...
Oh, right.
Completely inconsistent.
Yeah, no, I went to a meditation class.
Yeah.
So they said that studies show that you can really see it after 2 weeks at 45 minutes or something.
Yeah, but that's just that type of meditation that they studied in
the
brain.
Yeah,
so there's a lot of different ways to shift the brain waves. You know?
Yeah.
You know, if you run into an old lover in the grocery store, pretty instantaneous, stuff shifted. Like, it's not like, well, let's hang out for 45 minutes and see if my brain, no, like immediately around the frozen turkey, and you're like, what? Oh. And you're in a different, you know. Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. Very true.
Okay. So, we did the same breath count, but we're going to 5-5, then 5-6, then 5-7, then 5-8, 5-9, 5-10. 5-9, 5-8, 5-7, 5-6, 5-5. So it's always a 5 inhale. And you may have noticed before, but you are more likely to notice this time. It seems 5 seems to go fairly fast. Not that I'm looking at a clock, so
yeah.
I could be a little off, but either way, it seems to go a little fast.
Mm-hmm.
But then you start to enjoy the sound, because the sound stays. You know, there's a 10, and you can really hear, as opposed to kind of more of that.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a little bit of, wow. That's somebody's sort of Dharma name. Ease. 5 in through the nose, all the exhales through the mouth. If on 8 or 9, for example, it's getting less ease for you, you can just repeat the 8 a few times, you know, while we go on.
Oh my gosh, look. Gorgeous. The sky looks like it's on fire. Bright orange, pink, and magenta.